Hey guys, this is Joe, back for another episode of Farm Sim on Wind Chaser. So I just loaded the game, and this guy's gonna be doing his final passes on headland. This is field 3. Started south, east, and west. So that guy's doing his thing. One kennel. Finished up field 15 and 11 since the last video. Had to refill the seed tender, or this planter, is what I meant to say. And we're trying to get a little caught up on our field prep. Right now we're basically three fields ahead of the planter. Which is fine because we cover about 38 meters. Technically it should be 37, but we're covering 38 meters with this planter, and our field cultivators are covering a combined of 32 at 12 miles an hour, and we're covering, we're probably averaging 7 to 8 miles an hour planting. This planter is rated at 9 miles an hour, but this AR can pull it around 8. Has some pretty decent nutrient levels in this field. We're going to have to end up probably spraying it again anyways at some point during the harvest. First time, this will be the first year that we planted in worked this field. Same with 34 and as well as 11 and 15. We have a great demand coming up in corn, I saw. So we're going to be doing another crazy video of rented trucks racing to the grain bin, and it'll be interesting though because it's going to ConAgra, so we'll have issues of train to avoid, and a few other things. So once this fog raises, it will be a little bit easier to see, but I was thinking of putting another crop farm down here by where field 35 is, and just moving the field back a little bit. Just because this area is kind of bare, not a whole lot going on, and it has this weird triangle that I'm still not really sure what to turn it into. I was just going to make it into like a housing development, maybe. Or maybe just the woods. I'm not quite sure yet. But there's our GMC with the JMC tender. Farm on the hill in the distance. Had my endo exam today, went really well. So I have my last clinical tomorrow, and just a take-home exam that I already had finished. It was 153 questions of true and false. You gotta love those. The entire exam's 153 or 54 questions of true and false. So. Kind of annoying, but at least it was a take-home. So I'm planting the same way that I'll probably be harvesting, just because it's less interference of objects. In these irregular fields with multiple corners and we have a pretty high moisture in this field, which is great. It's not going to stay that way. You want it to be around 70% moisture. And our pK values are about 2 points too low. So we're going to end up probably broadcasting some pK. Looks like our cat is finished. Turn on our beacons. Alright, so basically the east side of our road is finished. Now we can start plugging away at 44 to 113. Looks like actually I'm gonna buzz in here and see what the nutrients are like in this field. 7, 5, 2. So yeah, this could use some going to go ahead and refill these anhydrous tanks. From our tank. So we'll go ahead and just refill that. Start this guy in fields. So I installed the new drive control mod, but I deleted out the lines for the fruit trample, so it doesn't trample the your crops, just because that it doesn't really, you know, as much as I use course play, it doesn't really work to have that in. Plus, I mean, the old wheel lane mod can easily be converted over from 13, where you actually put in the that you make the square yourself. And that way it's, you only have to put it on your tractors and trucks. It doesn't go to your trailers and wagons and stuff like that like it does now. Nice to have a planter that flexes with the ground like this one does. So it turns out if you use mod description 20, I know, you're allowed to have more than six components. So once I finish up the model of this planter, I'll be able to have the row units flex and have the outer wings flex as well. So looking forward to that. Just so this thing is extremely flexible on the ground. Which is interesting because in 13 it really didn't matter what mod description you had. You can have as many components as you wanted, so I think that's something that's new. If you use the lower original mod description, you get around that restriction, so. And then you can remake the crawler or terror track, whatever you want. You just change the prerequisites required and the LUA calls for. Because the only way you can use the crawler script on a trailer is if you have steerable specialization. But you can just like make a new XML with it and change the prerequisite. So I'm going to make a second version of the planner with tracks. Just because I'm kind of bored with wheels. So we're saving our money for trucks and trailers that we're going to rent to help us with our great demand of corn that's coming up today or tomorrow. So, it's pretty much the only map I've played since Farm Sim came out, so I don't even know what maps are available anymore. If any good ones. It just looks like they're all kind of like edited versions of the in-game maps. So this planner took forever to make. Just to find right schematics and pictures to build off of. And just the modeling itself took a fair amount of time because it's such a big implement. But I'm glad I made it. Use it all the time, it's very fun. I don't know what I would use to plant this map without it. It'd take forever. This is how Farm Sims should be. Too bad Giants doesn't make anything this big. Unfortunate. 8% on our tank of seed. See how far we can make it. We could probably make it back. Can you do it? Oh. Barely see our fields 11 and 15 that are planted, and most of 29. Well, I don't think we'll make it. Crap. So the direction that we're planting these crops is like erosion prone. We should be going the opposite way with the terrain, but well, we're making it easy on ourselves. Sliver of unplanted soybeans. Oh well. So next video, hopefully it will be another one of those crazy great demand videos of trying to get all of our crops in. It'll be at ConAgra, so it'll be interesting to see how the trucks do with the train. So thanks for watching.